Okay, so this is a video tutorial that's going to help you through the lab activity entitled Half-Life. And so here's your splashdown page, and the first thing, of course, you're going to hit begin. And notice in your instructions, it tells you that if you click up in the upper left-hand corner, there's really not that many controls to this activity, but by clicking on the upper left-hand box, the one that says, in most cases, it's going to be bismuth 211, notice that the thing that changes is the amount of decay, the decay per second. And you're going to want to choose your most active sample of bismuth 211. So click on this a number of times until you get it to its maximum value. Notice that once you do that, it immediately starts to record data. And so the first thing, once you've chosen the most active sample, is you're going to allow for 10 seconds of data, then you're going to hit hold, and that's going to freeze the count that you had in that first 10 second interval. And notice that the total time is continuing to run, but I just wanted to count and record the number of essentially decays that occurred in that first 10 seconds. And I'm going to put that in a data table. You're going to allow this to continue then until we get to 60 seconds. So again, I'm watching the total time. Once I get to 60 seconds, I'm going to hit reset. When I reset that, it's going to actually reset this counter. The time is going to continue to go along, but I'm going to reset the counter and essentially collect another 10 seconds worth of data. So again, I'm waiting for the 60 seconds to roll around here. I'm going to hit reset, and then I'm going to allow for 10 seconds of data collection, and then I'm going to hold again so I can record that value. So I'm getting to 60, and I reset it, and I'm going to let it collect for 10 seconds. Again, I'll hit hold, record my data, and continue to do that then for essentially 5 minutes. And so you're going to let it go, let your clock go up to 120 seconds, do 10 seconds worth of data, go up to 180, 240, 300, etc., collecting data the entire time. You'll also then, you know, once you've done that flawlessly, you'll want to collect data for three separate trials and then average the number of counts from those trials. So that's all part of your instruction. Once you've done that, then you can then plot your data. So this is in the next part of your instructions. It tells you to use the quick graphing program. So this is the quick graphing program, and it is very important that you put on the x-axis, you're going to put the time. So the time from your data table, time in seconds, if you wish. So of course that was the time that you began your time that you began collecting for those particular intervals. So we started out, our first little interval started at time 0, then we collected another time interval at starting at time 60 and 120 and 180 and 240 and 300. Then on the y-axis, that is going to be the average number of counts for those 10 second intervals. And remember, of course, you had three trials, you took an average, so you added up those individual values, divided by three, then that's where you're going to put that information. So you're going to, should have an average number of counts for each of these particular time intervals. Once you've done that, then make sure to go down to the fit option, and you're going to choose exponential decay, and that's going to fit your data, and it should be kind of a curve. And you'll want to make sure that your instructor, you're going to take a screen capture of your graph and post that to your instructor, but make sure you also include this little equation here. That's very, very important. Right now it says NaN. The thing that your instructor is going to be looking for is that NaN part. You should have numbers there. And that's a very important coefficient for the rest of the questions that make up this lab. Otherwise, just continue to follow the instructions in the lab, and it should be pretty straightforward. Good luck.